materials wisely. And don't forget to keep an eye out for supply drops.
Hello fellow gamers, I'm playing Fortnite Save The World, and in this video we're going to be doing the Last Stand Part 3. And it is for another banner, the third banner.
I forgot to mention the further complication. This is a genuine floor is lava situation.
And if you want to get this banner, you have to fully complete all 15 waves 5 times. And in the next video after this, I'm going to be doing the power level 140, Survive the Horde, and that is for another banner. The first three banners anyone can get at any power level, but the fourth banner you can only get if you do it in a power level 140. So unfortunately a lot of players aren't going to be able to get that banner because they're under leveled. You see there, two of the players in the team have actually got the power level 140 banner already. And I actually had some really awesome teammates for this Survive the Horde. They seemed to know what they were doing, which is good. I'm using my triple jump Dragon Scorch loadout again for this. It's just easier to get around the map, especially if you're trying to get those supply drops, which you need to get wood, stone and metal, and also for crafting ingredients as well. Now all these Survive the Horde videos were actually, footage was captured on the same day, but I'm actually releasing these or publishing these videos on a daily basis rather than publish all three of them in the same day. And I tend to use melee weapons quite a lot because, of course, they don't need ammo and you don't need to reload a melee weapon either. Because you only get a certain amount of ammo. Of course, you can craft your own ammo, but you require the crafting ingredients to do that. So I tend not to actually craft any ammo until I've actually crafted myself a Xenon bow, and then I only craft the energy cell ammo. Sometimes towards the end of the game I will use a defender and with an obliterator sniper rifle, and I will craft some heavy ammo for that defender. I'm actually looking forward to doing the power level 140 Survive the Horde. I'll be attempting that a bit later on today, and then I'll do a video on that tomorrow.
Commander, you won't make it out of there without supplies. Thankfully, supply drops are inbound.
See there in the distance, the green shows you where the supply drops are dropping. I didn't bother going for those because I could see that my teammates were going for them. You can shoot the supply drops down to make them drop faster as well if you wish. And the Xenon bow is actually great for shooting them down. what I'm doing here is I'm actually supporting the roof, because if the middle of the structure gets damaged by smashers, you still keep your roof basically. So that's why I do that. Still not enough crafting ingredients to make myself a weapon. It'll be easy in the power level 130 survive the horde, because of course you'll get those crafting ingredients, you know, a lot sooner.
Prepare for the next wave.
I will be able to craft myself a melee weapon and a Xenon bow a hell of a lot quicker than what I can in the power level 108 survive the hordes. And I've done 6 of these power level 108 survive the hordes and completed all 15 waves 5 times. We did fail one of them, and that was on the final wave, unfortunately. And I've only actually been knocked down once in all these games, and that you saw that in my my last video where I did the Last Stand Part 2. And, I think I was taken out by a taker. Well, I'm actually, again, not going to do a commentary all the way through this video. Tomorrow, I might do one throughout the power level 140, we should see. But sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Incoming. You'll need to destroy the pillars to end the wave. Thank you. waves of husks. The storm is targeting the depot. Wave of husks is on the way. On its way. The storm is targeting the cavern. Buckle up. This next wave is going to be awful.
Thank you.
more husks incoming. You'll need to destroy the pillars to end the wave. This next wave is gonna be, awful.
Thank you.
next wave. Destroy the pillars to end the wave. new wave of husks is on the way. Husks incoming. You'll need to destroy the pillars to end the wave. Attack. for the next wave. Incoming. You'll need to destroy the pillars to end the wave. Thank you. Another wave of storm creeps. Team has completed their snack stop and is on their way.
Yes, we've done it. All 15 waves completed. Brilliant. So, of course, we get our third new banner for completing The Last Stand Part 3. And as I said at the start of my video, you need to fully complete 5 Survive the Hordes to get this third banner. And you can be at any power level, you know, a Stoma player can get this, all these Survive the Horde banners, apart from the power level 140 Survive the Horde, because obviously they won't be a high enough level in order to get that banner. Of course, we get our usual loot, including the Battle Pass XP. And The Last Stand Part 3. I think that's the nicest banner out of all of them. It's got the three husks and then the two bones crossed below them. Nice. And let me know your thoughts in the comments. Are you enjoying Survive the Horde or perhaps not? Get our daily rewards, nice, and some V-Bucks as well, because I am a founder. I've been playing the Save the World since almost the beginning. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to smash that like button. If you're new to my channel, then why not subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye for now.